Hello, everybody. This is James Neesmith, and I've got just 2 minutes to win it on this morning. I was just thinking about the reality that so many times people don't want negative things in their life. I mean, come on, if you've got any sense at all, you don't want to go through rough patches of worry and doubt and stress and all that sort of thing. But the reality is, as we live, you know, you basically can't live in this life without going through something that's less than pleasurable. So as we think about it, it's okay, I can face these things and let them destroy me, or I can face these things and somehow benefit from them. And when we think about the way God has it structured in some kind of way, the things that destroy us are actually the things that can deliver us, or I should say the things we think will destroy us are the things that actually deliver us. You might remember James says it this way in James chapter 1 verses 2 and 3. He talks about the fact that we should count it all joy when we fall into various trials. Now, number one, James must be smoking something, because as we said, who wants to, you know, be joyful or think that it's a joyful thing to be in a negative circumstance? But that's from man's perspective, our human perspective. God, of course, has a perspective that's different. So he says, you know, count it all joy when you fall into these trials, knowing that the trying of your faith produces patience. It's like people often say you got to go through it in order to get to it. And sometimes that sounds a little trite. It sounds a little, I don't know, it seems to minimize the difficulty that so many of us go through. But the reality is, when I go through it, I can get to it. In the power of God, by His grace and with His mercy, the thing that is most destructive is the thing that becomes most constructive. You guys have a great day. We'll see you again.